pina-follow, sabi nyo nga, ang tawag nito, yung obligasyon ng Pogo sa ng Pogo na Lucky Star sa PAGCOR ang pinag-uusapan ninyo sa PAGCOR. So, due diligence, bilang abogado dun sa mga diskusyong iyon, alam nyo kung ano yung mga dokumentong sinumite, alam nyo yung mga official attachments na nakalagay doon. Did you confront Cassie Lin Ong about this? Or kinasuhan nyo ba siya na kung bakit nandun yung pangalan nyo sa organizational chart?
Madam, nagagalit po kayo dahil sinasabi nyo, binibigay ko ng mga salita ang inyong bibig. Pero right now, you already assumed...
Nagagalit. Sinasabi ko lang huwag niyong gawin yun.
Pero ngayon po, sinabi niyo, you again insinuated that I had anything to do with the document. Ayan nga po sinasabi ko. As far as I know,
Attorney, please stop using that offensive verb insinuating. I am a very plain speaker.
Okay,
pwede
I'm sorry.
Lang, oh, it's alright. Pwede okay. Nyo lang sabihin mali yung fact na mali sinasay, po. Tinatanggi nyo yung sinabi ng ibang resource person. Apat na taon na pong itong investigasyon. Halos wala na pong nag-i-insinuate kasi dire-diretso na pong mag-usap. Okay, so please tell the committee, kinonfront nyo ba si Cassie Lin Ong or kinasuan nyo ba siya? Bakit nandyan yung pangalan nyo sa organization?
Well, unang-una po, nalaman ko lang na nandun ang aking pangalan nung nag-hearing po last time dito na sinabi ni Chairman Altenco. Pero bilang abogado and naging professor na constitutional law, I'm familiar with the rules of the Senate and the Senate says that in proving facts, the rules of court apply in the supplitory character.
I don't need to argue with you about that, Attorney. But you don't need to, excuse me, sandali po. You don't need to tell the committee what the rules of the Senate are.
Well, I'm just citing
please just answer our question.
My answer po is that document is only evidence of its existence. Pero para patunayan po yung katotohanan na nakalasaad sa dokumentong yan, dapat meron pong testigo na nakakita ng ginawa yung dokumentong yan o di naman kaya testigo na gumawa ng dokumentong yan o di naman kaya yung testigo na pumirma ng dokumentong yan.
Actually, as I said earlier, excuse me. No.
Ma'am, excuse me kasi...
No. Excuse me, Attorney Roque.
I'm sorry, madam, but yes, I am a resource right. person invited.
Yes, you are. Wait,
let me finish. To answer.
Yes, you already answered in excess.
Kapag gusto niyo akong tumigil, papatigil niyo ako kapag ako nag-explain.
Yes.
I thought we were engaged in the search for the truth.
Oh, definitely we are. Attorney Roque, what I am saying, yes, and Sherwin.
Attorney Roque, please be reminded to respect the chairperson.
I'm very respectful, Madam Chair.
Paano respectful? Yung nagsasalita siya, sinasabayan mo siya.
I apologize, Senator Gachalian.
One more.
I apologize.
I will cite you in contempt. And if you disrespect the chairperson, we'll be compelled to cite you in contempt.
I understand and I apologize.
Kung naman sabayan siya, nagsasalita siya, siya ang chairperson.
Okay, Your Honor. I understand. I apologize.
Alright. Balikan ko po yung mga... tanong ko kay Attorney Roque.
Yes, Madam Chair.
Yes, thank you. All right. So, Attorney Roque, incorporator rin po kayo si Ms. Myla Roque at ang dating law partner niyo, incorporators po kayo sa Biancham, tama po?
That is correct. Biancham is my family holding corporation.
All right.
It's part of our estate planning.
All right. So, family holding corporation, part of your estate planning. And then, ngayon, ang email address po sa cover sheet ng Articles of Incorporation ng Biancham. All right. So, verbally i-redact ko na lang. Hindi ko na lang babanggitin yung email address. Isang observation sa kaninang pagtatanong, may layers ng ownership ng kumpanya ang bahay, pero lumalabas na kayo rin ito.
Well, I've never denied that and that's why I said that I have an interest in that house. But it has to be emphasized. Now, for purposes of search warrants, they have to specify the registered owner ng bahay. Kaya nga po, una-una, dinideny ko po na na-raid yung bahay ko dahil wala pong search warrant doon sa nangyari. Ang meron lang po, mission order at pag-aresto ng Bureau of Immigration sa dalawang Chinese nationals.
So, mission order po ang nag-cover ng raid?
Hindi po raid.
Sorry.
Ang apprehension po. Kasi ang raid po, wala pong search warrant at may abogado naman po yung mga foreigners na nakatira ron, hindi po sila pinapasok because under the Constitution and the Bill of Rights apply also to foreigners, hindi po sila po pwedeng pumasok na walang search warrant.
Briefly, Attorney Roque, I'll leave you to just ask a related question sa BI, mission order lamang daw ang dala at walang warrant. Can you educate a non-law enforcer like me?
Yes, Madam Chair. We confirm na during the arrest, the BI used the mission order. Wala pong Wala pong search warrant. Walang warrant of arrest.
All right. So apprehended yung dalawang tao at nasa custody ngayon ng PAOK.
Yes, yes, Madam Chair.
All right. Salamat po. Back to Attorney Roque. Can I confirm, opo? Can I confirm lang po na your wife, Ms. Myla Roque, is the managing director of Biancham since 2015 ayon sa annual report ng Pag-ibig.
Well, she was with Pag-ibig and she was managing director of Biancham, but she resigned. She resigned.
When po?
I cannot remember exactly when, but as I said, we filed an application to be part of the AFAB property and we appended a feasibility study. Meron pong malicious report sa media making it appear na yun ang kinikita na namin. Ayan po ay feasibility study. The requirement po yan ng AFAB kung kayo po ay mag-apply para maging kabahagi ng teritoryo ng AFAB. So dahil po doon, ayaw ng misis ko yung ganyang mga kontrobersiya, eh sabi po niya, I want out. At kaya nga po, ang nangyari po dyan, eh talagang nag-withdraw din kami doon sa project na yan because my wife said, I really want out. I want my privacy. No? At yan po ang dahilan kung bakit nagkaroon po ng change of ownership. At yan din po ang dahilan kung bakit recently, we are now taking moves to reclaim Biancham. No? Except that my wife really says, I want out. And that's also why we are contemplating even a separation of property para malinaw na hindi siya mai-involve sa aking mga business undertakings. The decision was made also because we had business reversals in a solar project kung saan dun ko po iniinganyo yung Whirlwind company, no? And we lost a substantial amount of money in that business transaction.
All right. Hanggang kailan managing partner yung asawa niyo sa Biancham?
Sandali lang po yan eh. Because yung investment po namin dyan sa First Bataan actually, and that was the controversy, was before I became congressman. And the controversy came out when I was a newly elected congressman, and that's when she wanted, that's when she verbalized that she wanted out dahil ayaw niya.
Anong taon po yun nung naging rep
siguro
kayo?
Siguro 2016 po ako naging rep dahil so nanalo po ako nung 2016 elections.
So she would have been managing partner for at least 1 year from 2015
to 2016.
1 year
lang po yan, hindi po nagtagal siya because she really wanted out. In fact, she wanted out of all my business transactions because gusto po niya maging pribadong individual.
Alright. But gaya ng ipinakita kong articles of incorporation, list of incorporators kanina kay Mr. De La Serna, may incorporators na nakalagay doon, isa rin po si Ms. Myla Roque.
Yes, so that's alright. What the document says po. Hindi po yan dinideny.
So just to summarize, yung house... Alright. Okay, before I summarize, regarding yung pinaplano yung takeover sa Biancham, so ibig sabihin ba, bibilihin nyo yung shares ni AR, bibilihin nyo yung shares ng ibang shareholders, or kaninong shares or kani-kaninong shares ang bibili ninyo para ma-effect yung takeover?
Ang share po ni AR is one share. Ang tawag lang po dyan, qualifying. Kasi bago po naamindahan ang corporation code, kinakailangan meron lima na directors at limang incorporators. Ngayon po, pwede na pong magkaroon ng one-man corporation. So, kaya po, yung mga nakalagay po dyan na one shareholder lamang, they are what is known as qualifying shares para makumpleto yung lima. Now, ang nangyari po kasi dyan is dahil we were also applying for an AFAB accreditation and at that time sa Kongreso po, nagkaring malaking issue yung pag-aari ni Congressman Florendo sa Tadeco, eh minabuti na rin po namin na lumabas muna doon sa investment sa Bataan. So nalugi po kami doon pero binalik ang pera namin na wala namang bawas, nawala lang kami ng interest. So yun po ang dahilan kung bakit nagbago po yung shareholdings ng Biancham. No? Pero ngayon po, as we speak, and even before this controversy, the papers are being drawn na babalik po ako. No? I'm going to repurchase the shares and I will register it soon. No? Dahil malinaw naman ang gusto mangyari ni Mrs. basta wala siyang kinalaman doon sa mga negosyo na pinapasok ko. So magiging malinaw ko anong sa kanya, anong sa akin, at para ang isusugal ko lang, to quote her words, is yung sa akin lang at hindi niya isusugal yung sa kanya at sa pamilya.
So, ibig sabihin po, i-buy out nyo sina Mr. De La Serna at yung iba pang shareholders para maging one-person corporation na yung Biancham sa inyo na po.
Well, actually, napirmahan na po nila lahat ng mga dokumento, no, papunta sa akin. Pero hindi pa po kami nagdonotaryo kasi inaayos pa. No? So, hindi naman po one-man corporation yan. Dahil sa totoo lang, kukuha rin po ako ng mga partners. So, magkakaroon din po kami ng reallocation pero mangyayari po ay babalik talaga po ako dyan.
So, just to summarize, yung bahay na naging subject ng mission order para ma-apprehend yung dalawang tao na associated sa Pogo Hub sa Bamban. That house is owned by PH2. PH2 is owned by Biansham. And your wife was managing director for about a year of Biansham.
Yes po.
Alright.
Yes.
So we will just do more research on that.
And because it is owned by PH2, Madam Chair, corporation under the laws approved by Congress have separate personalities from the individuals constituting the corporation.
Sige po. So those are my questions. Sorry. So just to continue, Attorney Roque. So even after the testimonies of Chair Tengco and Attorney Fernandez, minimaintain nyo pa rin po ba na hindi kayo lawyer ng Lucky South 99 o kahit anong POGO for that matter?
I confirm that 100%. And the reason po is, daladala ko po ngayon ng mga dokumento. Alam nyo po, ang attorney-client relations, kinakailangan po yan magkasundo ang partido because it is the highest fiduciary relationship. Kaya nga po yung tinatawag na attorney-client privilege, miski dito po sa Kongreso, hindi nyo mapapakontep kapag na-invoke yung attorney-client privilege. At sa totoo lang
within
po,
certain limitations, of course.
At sa totoo lang po, sana kinuha po ako ng Lucky Star na abogado. Bakit po? Dahil yung raid sa PORAC, unconstitutional po yan. Nag-raid po sila, kumuha sila ng warrant of arrest galing sa Bulacan judge outside of jurisdiction.
Excuse me, sige. Well, hindi natin ini-investiga ano yung raid. We are investigating
the Pogo. Yes, ma'am, but I'm just saying.
So,
kasi,
please just make your answer to this short. Kasi it was actually just a yes or no question.
Ma'am, but ma'am, let us be fair because you have been insinuating I am a lawyer for Lucky South. That is why...
Excuse me, the chair has not been insinuating anything. The chair and the members of the committee have been asking questions based on the testimonies, sworn testimonies of PAGCOR Chair Tengco, Attorney Fernandez of PAGCOR, and other resource persons. So the resource person will not impute any insinuation to the chair. Will please just answer the questions. The chair has given the resource person
Your Honor,
leeway to answer
the questions. In the interest
please
of fairness, may I be allowed to dispute then the statement of the prior resource persons?
We will get to that in the
okay, so the question again, Madam Chair, is
do you maintain na hindi kayo abogado ng Lucky South 99 or any POGO for that matter?
I maintain as an officer of the courts and under oath before the Senate of the Republic of the Philippines that I have never acted as legal counsel for Lucky South 99 or for any other POGO.
Alright. Pero tama naman pong totoo na nakipag-meeting kayo sa PAGCOR tungkol sa POGO sa PORAC. Yes,
totoo po yun. Nakipag-meeting ako. But as I said, ang aking kasama po ay kakilala ko bilang Whirlwind Corporate Secretary and I have documents in my possession which I would like to submit now to the Senate.
Yes,
kasi iba po yung usap-usapan lang, iba kapag notaryadong dokumento.
Okay. And definitely, yung pagtestimonya ng ibang mga resource persons ay hindi rin lamang usap-usapan at may mga sinasubmit ding dokumento. Otherwise, the committee would not bother inviting them again and again to
Madam,
excuse me. I'd just like to ask the next question. So, ang topic ng mga meeting at pag-uusap nyo sa PAGCOR, and in fact, mga pag-follow-up nyo sa PAGCOR, ay utang ng Lucky South 99 ng mismong POGO. Tama po ba?
Yes, tama po yun.
Alright, salamat. So, hindi lang talaga Whirlwind, Lucky South 99 din.
Pwede ba mag-explain?
Pwede naman po.
Okay, kasi po, ang Whirlwind is not only the lessor, they're also the service provider. Now, I appeal now to the officials of PAGCOR. Siguro kayo po mag-explain kung anong ginagawa ng service providers, including Chair Andre Dominguez because I had an opportunity to work with her. Domingo, no? Ang service providers po, sila talaga ang nagbibigay ng lahat na kinakailangan ng mga POGO operators kasi POGO operators po, lahat yan Chino. Hindi po yan nag-i-Ingles. Kaya nga po, meron silang mga representative sa PAGCOR dahil sila mismo, they have no ability to communicate dahil nag-establish na nga sila ng mga independent POGO hubs. So ang pagkakaintindi ko po talaga, trabaho po ng service provider na magbigay ng serbisyo sa kanilang mga kliyente.
Alright, Attorney. Salamat. The committee will ask further questions sa PAGCOR. Balik na lang po tayo dito sa Lucky South at PAGCOR. No? Ang sabi po nyo, you did not authorize the use of your name in the organizational chart that was submitted as an official attachment by Lucky South 99 to PAGCOR.
Totoo.
So, kasalanan po yan ni Cassie Lin Ong, tama ba?
Hindi po. Kasalanan po yan ang kung sinong gumawa.
Eh, sino
dahil wala
gumawa?
Naman pong establishment. Gumawa po niyan, Lucky South.
Yes.
Dahil sila po nag-a-apply.
Na si Cassie Lin Ong ang isang ano doon.
Wala po pa tayong ebidensya na nagpapakita kung sino nag-submit talaga ng mga dokumento, but PAGCOR can confirm kung sino talaga nag-submit ng mga dokumento yan.
Okay, we will pero, ask PAGCOR that again later. We asked them before. Basta ang malinaw po sa komite ay yung organizational chart na yan na may drawing, may box, na legal, na nandun yung pangalan nyo, was one of the official attachments sa submissions ng Lucky South 99 sa PAGCOR. And sabi nyo nga, yung obligasyon ng Pogo sa ng Pogo na Lucky Star sa PAGCOR ang pinag-uusapan ninyo sa PAGCOR. So, due diligence bilang abogado dun sa mga diskusyong iyon, alam nyo kung ano yung mga dokumentong sinumite, alam nyo yung mga official attachments na nakalagay doon. Did you confront Cassie Lin Ong about this? Or kinasuhan nyo ba siya na kung bakit nandun yung pangalan nyo sa organizational chart?
Madam, nagagalit po kayo dahil sinasabi nyo binibigay ko ng mga salita ang inyong bibig. Pero right now, you already assume...
Nagagalit. Sinasabi ko lang wag nyong gawin yun.
Pero ngayon po, sinabi nyo, you again insinuated that I had anything to do with the document. Ayan nga po ang sinasabi ko. As far as I know,
Attorney, please stop using that offensive verb insinuating. I am a very plain speaker.
Okay,
pwede
I'm sorry.
Lang, oh, it's all right. Pwede okay. nyo lang sabihin mali yung fact na mali sinasay, po. Tinatanggi nyo yung sinabi ng ibang resource person. Apat na taon na pong itong investigasyon. Halos wala na pong nag-i-insinuate kasi dire-diretso na pong mag-usap. Okay, so please tell the committee, kinonfront nyo ba si Cassie Lin Ong or kinasuan nyo ba siya bakit nandyan yung pangalan nyo sa organization?
Well, unang-una po, nalaman ko lang na nandun ang aking pangalan nung nag-hearing po last time dito na sinabi ni Chairman Altenco. Pero bilang abogado and naging professor ng constitutional law, I'm familiar with the rules of the Senate and the Senate says that in proving facts, the rules of court apply in the supplitory character.
I don't need to argue with you about that, Attorney. But you don't need to, excuse me, sandali po. You don't need to tell the committee what the rules of the Senate are.
Well, I'm just citing
Please just answer our question.
My answer po is, that document is only evidence of its existence. Pero para patunayan po yung katotohanan na nakalasaad sa dokumento yan, dapat meron pong testigo na nakakita ng ginawa yung dokumento yan, o di naman kaya testigo na gumawa ng dokumento yan, o di naman kaya yung testigo na pumirma ng dokumento yan.
Actually, as I said earlier, excuse me.
Ma'am, excuse me.
Attorney Roque.
I'm sorry, madam. But yes, I am a resource right. person invited.
Yes, you are. Wait,
let me finish. To answer.
Yes, you already answered in excess.
Kapag gusto niyo akong tumigil, papatigil niyo kapag ako nag-explain.
Yes.
I thought we were engaged in the search for the truth.
Oh, definitely we are. Attorney Roque, what I am saying, yes, and Sherwin.
Attorney Roque, please be reminded to respect the chairperson.
I'm very respectful, Madam Chair.
Paano respectful? Yung nagsasalita siya, sinasabayan mo siya.
I apologize, Senator Gachalian.
One more.
I apologize.
I will cite you in contempt. And if you disrespect the chairperson, we'll be compelled to cite you in contempt.
I understand and I apologize.
Kung naman sabayan siya, nagsasalita siya, siya ang chairperson.
Okay, Your Honor. I understand. I apologize.
Salamat, Sen. Sherwin. At salamat, Attorney Roque, sa apology nyo kay Sen. Sherwin. All I'm saying is, there is no need for any resource person to cite the rules of the Senate to a Senate committee. We know that. So please just answer the questions which are being asked of each resource person at length with an embarrassment of time para masagot nyo yung mga tanong. But please stick to the topics and do not lecture a Senate committee about the rules of the Senate committee. We know that. We correct ourselves kapag lumalabag kami doon. So, I suppose your answer is hindi kayo nagreklamo kay Cassie Lin Ong at hindi nyo siya kinasuhan kung bakit nandun yung pangalan nyo sa chart.
As I said, madam, nalaman ko lang po yung pangalan ko nasa chart during the last hearing. Ang sinasabi ko po under oath as an officer of the court, hindi ko po inauthorize ang paglagay ng pangalan ko doon. Wala pong kinalaman sa paggawa ng dokumentong yan at wala pong kahit anong testimonya sa kahit sino na gumawa ng testimonya na nagsasabi na pumayag po ako. And I deny that under oath.
All right. And sa interview nyo naman po kina Ted Filon at DJ Chacha, inamin nyo, quote, dinulog sa akin yung problema ni Cassie yung nangyari sa Lucky South. So mula mismo sa bibig ninyo, interes ng mismong Pogo ang meeting at fina-follow up nyo o inaareglo sa PAGCOR.
Kasi nga po, si Cassie ay service provider ng Lucky South. So gaya po ng sinagot din ni Dennis Cunanan, pag may problema ang Lucky South, tumatawag sila doon sa mga tao na tutulungan sila dahil hindi nga po nag-i-English yung mga yan.
Okay. So but, whether service provider o ano pa man, dinulog nyo yung problema ni Miss Cassie Leong at ng Lucky South na isang Pogo, idinulog nyo sa PAGCOR.
Dinulog ko po right. Dahil pinakiusapan po ako nung service provider. Dahil wala po akong kahit sinong kakilala sa Lucky South.
Well, kilala nyo si Cassie Leong, siya, Lucky South po siya.
Ay, hindi ko po siya kakilala as Lucky South dahil ito po ang mga dokumento nagpapakita na siya ay pumirma sa mga pleadings na ginawa ko nung ako po'y re-retain mga 2 weeks after that meeting para sa kasong ejectment. Kaya nga po paulit-ulit ako, hindi po nagtagal matapos yung meeting na yon, dinulog po sa akin itong mga kaso. At tatlong kaso po yan at lahat po ito ngayon isusumitik ko sa ating komite na nagpapatunay po na ang aking kliyente sa mga kasong ito ay will win at ang pumirma po ay si Cassie Ong bilang corporate secretary. Madam, I'm now turning over these documents and this consists of number 1, ad cautela motion to quash or recall writ of execution filed before Branch 114 of the Regional Tri-Court of Angeles City, omnibus motion for its manifestation entry of appearance, and second manifestation, remand of the case to MTC, filed before the Municipal Trial Court of Porac, Pampanga, both of which contain the filing with our consent by one Catherine Cassandra L. Ong, Corporate Secretary, Whirlwind Corporation. And of course, the third one is a petition for annulment of judgment with application for temporary restraining order and writ of preliminary injunction, docketed as CA GR number 18013, filed with the Court of Appeals, also bearing verification and consent signed by Cassandra L. Ong as Corporate Secretary of Whirlwind Corporation.
Salamat, okay, Attorney. Yes, ComSec, paki-receive kay Attorney
Corporate Roque. Secretary, Your Honor.
To the Committee Secretary. Yes, thank you.
Ay, to the Committee Secretary.
Yes. Speaking of Cassie Leong again, in contact po ba kayo sa kanya? Baka naman pwede niyong sabihan siya na mag-show up na dito.
I will advise her to show up dahil kinakailangan talaga, especially to prove kung ano talaga yung reklamo niya kay Mr. Dennis Cunanan.
Salamat. At kung nasa Singapore na siya, malapit lang naman mag-fly back. Ngayon, Attorney, Lucky South has 99 has had issues of criminality and illegal activity since 2021, and yet pinasilitate nyo itong problem-solving session sa PAGCOR.
Bakit ma'am, po? Ang totoo po dyan ay, again, PAGCOR should be the one to clarify this. Yung na-in trouble po dyan is a sub-licensee. Dahil tinanong ko po si Cassie dyan. Yung panahon po na meron pang sub-licensee at mother's title po, mother license ang Lucky South, ang na-in trouble po dyan ay hindi po doon sa Porac. Doon po siya sa Friendship Highway. So it is
saan
a sub-licensee.
Anong pangalan?
Ang Friendship Highway po ay, it's also in Angeles City, no, not in Porac anymore. Pero yan pong na-raid is not the Porac facility. It is a different location, a sub-licensee of Lucky
South. Ano pong pangalan ng sub-licensee?
Ay, pareho naman po lahat yan eh. And the PAGCOR officials can confirm this.
So it's also Lucky South 99?
Well, because ginagamit po nila yung lisensya dahil nung unang panahon, allowed po ang mga sub-licensee at nandiyan naman po ang past and present leadership ng PAGCOR. Kaya hindi po naapektuhan ang operation ng Lucky South dahil na-establish naman na hindi po yung Lucky South na nag-ooperate sa Porac ang may pagkakasala dun sa raid na yon.
Well, definitely the committee will get back to the current PAGCOR chair dahil napaka-unequivocal yung pagkasabi na Lucky South 99 mismo ang may problema. Okay, so Attorney, ayaw nyo mang amining abogado kayo ng Pogo. Malinaw na abogado naman kayo ng taga-areglo ng Pogo.
So, bukod
pa dyan, excuse me Attorney, sandali po. Bukod pa dyan, ang pag-areglong ginawa nyo sa PAGCOR nangyari noong 2023. Pero gaya ng nabanggit ko kanina, noong 2022 pa lang, ni-raid na ang Lucky South 99 dahil sa human trafficking. At hindi po isang sub-licensee ng Lucky South sa Friendship Highway o kahit saan paman, but yung Lucky South dun sa Porac. Ito po ang tanong ko. Sa kabila ng lahat ng yan, at kahit alam yung trabaho ng Whirlwind, na protektahan ang interes ng Pogong, may track record ng kriminalidad, umayag pa rin kayong maging abogado nila. Tama po ba?
Tama po yun kasi wala naman akong nalaman na merong raid noong 2021. Kasi na-meet ko na lang po sila tapos na ang eleksyon. Na-meet ko na sila nung bumalik na ako sa aking private practice 2022 at hindi ko naman sinusubaybayan kung sino talaga yung mga na-raid ng 2021. At ang pagkakaalam ko po, sila ay Whirlwind kasi nga po 2 weeks after our meeting, lahat ng dokumento na pinirmahan nila kung saan nila ako re-retain as lawyer ay sa ngalan po ng Whirlwind. Again, fully documented po yan.
So pero ang nasa likod ng isip ko kasi yung pagpulong nyo ni Cassie Leong ng Lucky South 99 sa PAGCOR. So, inaamin nyo po ba na ang pag-areglo nyo sa PAGCOR ay para sa Lucky South 99 at hindi para sa Whirlwind lamang?
Hindi po. Ang aking tinulungan po ay Whirlwind. Kasi noong panahon po yan, hindi ko nga po kakilalang Whirlwind bilang isang kliyente. Kakilala ko po sila dahil iniinganyo ko sila mag-invest sa mga energy projects. So yung pagsama ko po sa kanila, well, if we go by the Supreme Court definition of attorney-client, yes, meron pong attorney-client relation, pero it was more of an accommodation. Wala po kami engagement. Hindi po ako bayad doon. Nagkaroon lang kami ng engagement 2 weeks after dahil nga po dito sa ejectment case na nangyari. So kumbaga, that was part and parcel of my effort to entice them to invest into projects that I'm pushing for renewable energy dyan sa Cebu. At in a time span po of mga 1 year, talaga naman pong, well, frustrated po ako dahil hindi ko rin sila nainganyo. But ang naging sumatotal po, naging tutor nila ako for renewable energy. At ang desisyon nila, bago ang pangyayari ng lahat, ay sila magde-develop ng sarili nilang solar farm at magtatayo pa di umano ng isang integrated solar panel manufacturing facility. No? So medyo nainis po talaga ako doon dahil nga ang dami kong oras na ginugol. Pero pampalubag loob, ang sabi naman ng Whirlwind, bibigyan ka namin ng shares, founder shares, dahil ikaw ang tutor namin dito sa negosyong ito.
Salamat, attorney. Yun lang yung mga tanong ko sa inyo ngayong araw. But please stay because I'm sure my colleagues will have questions for you.
Salamat din po. And again, I apologize. Alam nyo naman po, init ng damdamin. Salamat. Kasi kung makikita nyo po yung release ng PAGCOR, abay, ako dahil naglabi para sa illegal na logo. Hindi naman po yun ang sinabi ni Altenco. I appreciate it, Mr. Altenco. Pero dapat naman po, call your attention of your PR department na nag-issue ng press release. Kasi yung hindi nyo na po pinangalanan kung sino yun, parang showbiz, talaga pong sinabi nila na mayroong ex-cabinet member na nag-intercede para sa lisensya sa isang illegal pogo. Eh, hindi naman po talaga yung pangyari. And I appreciate that you said the truth before this committee.
Alright, salamat, attorney. Yung mga side discussions, on the side na lamang po. Alright.
So, hanggang dito lang tayo mga tol. Maraming salamat sa panonood at patuloy na suporta. God bless you sa inyo lahat at hanggang sa muli. Paalam.